For this tutorial, we'll look at how to use VR for fitness dance. For VR fitness, it's best to use a wireless headset. I'm currently using the Quest 2, but if you're looking to buy, the Quest 3 will be released soon. Out of the box, the headset is very front heavy. This means that if you're jumping up and down, the front of the headset will wobble up and down. To balance the weight of the headset and also extend the battery life, I'm using the Meta Elite strap. The strap is rigid and will extend the playtime by about 2 hours. I've added an additional comfort kit to the Elite strap. There are also many third-party straps available for the Quest 2. The head strap is very easy to replace. The side straps just clip off and clip on, and the top strap is just attached using Velcro. With the additional weight of the battery at the back, the headset is better balanced and won't sag in the front while jumping. The original facial interface is quite uncomfortable. I've changed it out for a vented sports interface. This has a guard to stop light leaking in through around the nose, and it uses Velcro to allow you to change and wash the foam padding. The facial interface just clips into the headset. Although some games can be played directly in the headset, it's best to use a powerful gaming PC or gaming laptop to run the games. The video output from the games can be streamed over Wi-Fi directly into the headset. You should also have a good quality Wi-Fi access point which supports beamforming. It's possible to connect your headset to your PC using AirLink for free. However, most people use an app called Virtual Desktop. This allows for a lot more customization and options. It will cost around $20 in the App Store. I'll link a referral code in the description for 25% off. However, you don't need to use this. There are many dancing studios available in VRChat. I'm going to use one called VR Dancing. When joining the dance studio, I will try to align the walls of my room to the walls of the dance studio. I do this by turning and clicking the respawn button. This is what tracking looks like only using the Quest. As you can see, only the head and hands are tracked. To improve tracking, I'm using Vive 3.0 trackers. I have a dedicated pair of shoes for VR. The trackers can be attached using the shoelaces. For the hip tracker, I have a track belt and use it looped through a pair of pants. Each tracker comes with its own USB dongle. The trackers should be tight enough so that they don't wobble. For this test, I'll show what tracking is like using only one base station. To use the Quest 2 and the Vive trackers together, you need some additional software called OpenVR Space Callibrator. Calibration can be done by holding the controller and tracker together and moving them around together. When the calibration is completed, the Vive trackers should show up in the correct location. Here I have my hip tracker on my left side, but the single base station is on the front right. So you can see that it loses tracking when it doesn't have line of sight to the base station. For the next part, I'll switch to using Valve Index controllers. These controllers come with straps which allows you to open your hands without dropping the controllers. Like the Vive trackers, they are tracked through base stations. They also have finger tracking. In the virtual desktop streaming settings, make sure Center to Play Space is enabled. Also disable the track controllers option to use the index controllers instead of the quest controllers. I've restarted Steam VR. To calibrate the play space, I'll select the headset and one of the index controllers, then move the controller and headset together by holding onto the headset. The finger tracking is great on these controllers, and the controllers will also be tracked behind your back. In this example, I'm using two base stations for tracking. This allows me to turn around without losing any tracking. For the final example, I will add on four more trackers, two elbow trackers, a chest tracker with a chest strap, and a tracker for the headset to use with continuous calibration. To calibrate, I will select the tracker that's attached to my headset and select continuous calibration. Make sure hide target device from application is selected. Then, as the headset moves, it will continuously update the calibration. I've also changed my small dongle to a larger dongle. This Tundra dongle can connect up to four devices. This is what tracking looks like with four base stations, a chest tracker, and elbow trackers. Here's a comparison of all four tracking videos. There are many dancing studios in VRChat. Also, there are Discord communities that arrange dancing sessions. One of the more popular worlds is called Pai Pai Dance. This instance of Pai Pai Dance is the Japanese server, so a lot of the avatars are in anime style. Due to the lag of the server, the movement of the other players will be slightly delayed from the music. There are also some multiplayer songs to choose from, which are great for dancing with friends. I hope you found this video useful. Leave a comment and go join a virtual dancing community.
Ludies, thank you so much for joining us.